Just going to cover this as a really basic attack. Anytime I'm hands behind, I'm holding my partner onto me, which means that he doesn't really have to do anything. So I want to get my hands to the inside position. And inside position means that I can create space to be able to move. The biggest thing about moving is that it's not the space that I'm creating, it's the ability to get off my back. So a lot of people get the frames in here and they bridge, but they're still kind of connected to the partner. So when I come back down, my back's still on the ground, I still can't rescue guard and I still can't hip escape. So what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to create a space here, but all I'm doing is I'm getting a little bit of separation between my partner and myself. So if you have a look at it this way, anytime that I'm bridging and pushing, I'm pushing him back onto my hips. So even if I do move, I'm behind the hip line. This is better for Brendan to step up to knee, ride, mount, etc. Right? So it's far better for him. So what I'm trying to do instead is my hand position, right, is I'm trying to get my elbows high. But once again, is if I'm flat onto my back, all I'm doing is creating space for him now. I go, look, I'll just put my knee onto Adam's stomach again, and it's easy for him to upgrade. So I want to create a space that's usable for me. And how do I do that? So I flare my right knee. So my partner's on my right side, my right knee. I flare, step. This is one of the hardest parts I see people do is step and roll my leg flat so I can turn. So watch again. From here is I step, I roll my hip flat. So what happens now is if Mr. Young tries to go to knee ride, the area is quite large and I can keep him at bay. Number two, it's very hard for him to get to mount now because the distance I've created makes it hard for him to step. And he'll have to step over, which creates a space for me to bring my knees on the inside. Okay. So we're going to go like this. Nice, easy warm-up, okay? So left leg, right leg, left elbow, flare. Leg goes straight and push. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to circle my hand under the armpit and now I'm going to drive my elbow back to my head. So see how I'm not moving? But he's doing all the work for me. I'm not moving. So again, side control. I can't do this without creating a space for me to use him. So my left leg, my right leg. Okay, elbow high, not hand high. Flare, turn here. Frame goes on the inside position, like I'm doing the robot. So here, and what I'm doing is I'm driving my elbow backwards to put my partner over me. I make zero contact, that's all I do is grab him and pull him back on top of me so I can't move. In fact, I want to kind of shove him with my hand so I'm popping out the back. One more time. How'd that feel?
Solid.
That was exactly what I was after. Okay. Yes, bud.
Would you ever use your left knee as well to boot the bar?
We'll do that, but I've still got to go backside on him to get there. So at the moment, I'm not backside, and I'm going to say backside one more time. Backside. Okay, so from here, backside. Okay, so left leg, right leg. Now watch this. Kick, use my elbow creates a space for me to turn. I robot, so my hand comes through this little valley here. What I should do is both grab. So he can now go overhook, dogfight, etc. To evade that is my elbow goes backwards. The reason why I'm not kneeing him up the butt at the moment is my right hand's still compromised, so I need to pull my right hand out before I do anything else. So now I have a space to nudge him into. Sometimes I see people nudge, but they nudge and it's like, oh man, his weight's straight back on top of me, cares, etc. So I do want to clear the debris before I do any nudging, before I get up. So I just want to get to this. If you're having trouble getting up into your hand, right, so I've done the nudge, I'm here, and I'm having trouble going elbow first. Sometimes going from here to your hand's quite awkward, so pull your elbow backwards, and you can go to your hand. Okay, one, two, three.
Now,
I miss it with Lewis. It's a really difficult thing to do because what you see people do and what you do is normally completely different. It's just one of those things, like I'm doing what Adam did or Coach Adam did, and I'm looking at you like, what the fuck are you doing? That's nothing like what I did. But yes, it is. No, it's not. I'm like, get out of my gym. Okay. So from here, so right leg. Now watch what I see. If I turn my left leg here, my hips and knees are still facing the wrong way. I can't recover guard. So right leg, sorry, left leg. Now what I'm doing is, it's my right foot and I turn and raise my elbow. So I'm trying to still face my partner. So it's my foot makes contact, not my knee. Don't bring your knees together. Your foot makes contact. Okay. As I'm sliding, my toes turn, my elbow turns, and here. this is the part I think you have a lot of issues with, like this. So through this belly here, I'm throwing my arm, but it has to be elbow deep. Now, anytime I extend my arm, he's got the ability to wrap it. So what I'm doing is I'm keeping, yeah, like anytime I extend, well, what I'm trying to do for me is, it's just my elbow. So if he goes to overhook, there's actually nothing to overhook. Where if I'm going whole arm, got it. So on the shark, it's elbow only. Once I've cleared it, then I can start to recover. So I see people from here, they're like, oh, and they go here. Yeah. Where if I go here, even if it goes to overhook, but it's a very difficult position. So I want this like a monkey kind of stretching it here. And what I'm doing is elbow recover on the hips. If I come up high, he's got the inside position so he can unhook and whiz and dog fight again. Wherever I'm on the hip, even if he swings his hand backwards, he's going that way, then that just may knock him over because he's swinging his hands that way. Okay, 1, 2, 3. To weigh, and they don't move to far enough around to the side. So I tried the 6 to 9 year olds yesterday in this, and they rocked it out. So see how you guys go. No pressure. So I'm just gonna grab Emma onto her back, and in a nutshell, right? So I'm gonna keep this as a very very basic movement. And we can kind of improvise as we go through from here. So number one is, I'm on the side control position and Emma creates the space for me, okay? So as she starts to move away, so I already realized that like this side of the body is hard to attack. Mainly because the frame system's in on the inside and her knees are facing towards me. Anytime I step over, she's gonna get the inside position. Okay. What happens now though is the top side is exposed and this is exposed. Does that make sense? Because she's had to raise the elbow. The downfall for me is that my hand's on this side. So what I'm gonna do from here is, as she starts to get the unhook, I put my hand through, and all I'm gonna do is I'm trying to get my hand so it's wedged between her arm, between her elbow and my armpit. Now, I'm gonna knee ride her belt. So post, knee ride the belt, and sit to my armbar. Until I sit to the armbar where I'm 90 degrees or less, Emma can roll her legs this way because she's the armbar. Anytime I sit 90 degrees plus, she can't roll out because I have a better control. Even if she does, it exposes the arm. So what I'm saying is, when I sit onto the knee line, I've got to make sure that I'm going belt line, so just belt line, not that side. You're actually better off that side. It's dictated by where you put your hand. 100% dictated by where you put your hand. So here, as she frames, I come under and here. So if I put my hand right close to her legs, it's easy for me to go to here because that's kind of like the line I want to go to. Where if I put my hand back here, I get a 5-minute spin. So the more that I put my post hand to this side, the better my spin. The more I put my post hand down to her knees, the worse my spin. So, side control, she creates space, pushes me up, 1, 2. So I'm kind of almost going this way. So tight to the armpit. Boom. I don't have the arm. I now grab the arm.
Once you step down, is that way
for
you coming in on the angle to
pinch under it? So, as Emma turns towards me, bop. Okay, so watch carefully. I'm gonna go hand takes that, and all I wanna do is this side. My hand comes to this side, as close to the armpit, not the hip. I don't care if she moves at the moment, I just wanna block it out, okay? So, as I step, and I knee right, it's gonna put me in the position to claim the arm. Now, the beautiful thing about it is that if Emma does go, I'm in an armbar, catches the hands together, but I go drop to my knees, sit belt grip. The hand, the elbow underneath the head goes high. The elbow on her belt drives low. The hand underneath the head drives high. So even if I don't get the arm bar, I'm in a really nice position for the back take or to the transition around my partner. So Emma's on top. So Emma's on the cycle drop. Just gonna go slow, okay. So the precursor is, she goes, I've created space, so she has to acknowledge I'm in a better position. So as I underhook, goes round. Now the hand, close to my armpit. Now watch carefully, we're just gonna take the big step, try to end up going right to the side. And now, the thing is you wanna sit down, so claim my arm, sit down. So we have the arm bar. Got it? If I capture the arm, we're gonna go like this. You take this knee off my head and put your knee behind my head and come up to your knees. Nice. Hands come together. The hand underneath the elbow, underneath the head, locks up high. This one compresses my hip. Just sit me up. Hook goes in this side first. Because I'm going to try and spin that way, so hook stays in. If you try and put this hook in first, or you crush it, and you can't come over it. So if this hook goes in first, and you try and lock me this way, that clears your secondary hook.
Yeah, exactly.
So I can't stop that hook coming in. And once I try and do this, this is arm bar and choke and all that as well. So, yes, sir?
Because if you go
on your knees backside, you don't need to post, because if you post, what's holding me?
No.
Yeah, so if you try and ramp me to back control here, I'm just going to recover, so you need to get the seatbelt grip. So how you ramp is this comes up, so you kind of drive that elbow down, and that you don't actually need to do anything. And now, the hook comes in first, drop to the side. I can't stop the secondary hook, you flare your elbow, hook comes in. And even if I try and turn from here, you've got the ability to stab my hips to keep me posted. So you've got both the arm bar, and if you miss the arm bar, you've got the back take as well. Two really crucial positions. The idea for me is if I'm coming around to the armbar and I see that they're possibly going to get the C grip or defend the armbar, I'll stop at the north-south kind of position and take the boat ramp to back control instead. If I feel that the arm's separated, I'll just continue through to the armbar. Okay, 1, 2, 3.
Go passing, feet up. Any time that their legs are away from the body, I have the landing zone. Anytime the knees are into the body, I don't have a landing zone. Anytime that hands are legs away from the body, I can play the inside position. Anytime that the knees are in the body, she always gets the inside position. So it's not just about taking space, it's about fighting for the inside position. We're going to go this case, so it's very, very simple. And I want you guys to remember what we're doing. So I control, Emma gets the inside position from here. As I start to step 45 degrees backwards and clean the legs, Emma gets the opportunity to shoot the underhook. Right. Okay. So now, watch carefully from here. I'm going to do exactly the same. I can leave my right leg trapped in there. Most times you're going to have a hard time getting your right leg out because they want the half guard. Okay. So, come under. So instead of fighting for this position, I'm fighting for this position. Right. So instead of fighting for this control, so under, step, switch and sit. The beautiful thing about it is that they're normally going to try and keep the leg in here, but the leg squeeze, they normally have to keep me on that side. If they do roll towards me, I can pull my leg out. Right, so one of the things I see here is I get to here. What I want is to here.
Did you ever put intention here though?
100%.
Yeah.
100%. So what I'm doing now, the reason being is that it keeps her controlled, so she can't move towards me because it's pinned with my hamstring. So now, as I slowly roll my knees, you say, oh, Miss Young, sorry, I've got a bit of you. Yeah. I don't want to hurt my wife in video.
Just mentally.
So, inside position, he gets the control, so he gets
sleeve control, and can go foot control as well if I want to. Step 45 degrees backwards, pull the leg here, then shoot the unhook. And 9 out of 10 times you're going to try and keep the leg as well.
Okay?
So, disengage. Step. Okay. Foot here. Now, what I'm saying to you guys is from here, kick the leg that side. Same concept. Hold. So even if he kicks the foot inside the thing, you still squeeze half guard. So I'll put my arms on his head. That's good. So what I'm saying is, the reason why this is here.
It's really a quarter guard.
Of course,
it's a lot of
it. So the concept behind this is that if my partner, he would generally want to roll this way, exactly this way. But of course, he's holding my leg. It's difficult to do. As long as I keep this here. So what I'm doing is I bring my knees up. And that will help me to retract my leg. Of course, he never gets a really good bite on the half guard. So watch him.
When you're coming round, that should be always underhooking his left knee as well. So you have more control to the
So the thing about this way, okay, to clear the hook, step,
drag, control.
So this is keeping him at bay.
Under. Clear, clear. Sit up. So I have the control. If they cut their hands together from this position, this is a triangle. Reverse triangle. Outside grip. Rock and roll, keep it through, lock it up, push the wrist.
Yep.
Jack space, push the wrist down. How'd that feel?
Yeah, crushing my shoulder into the triangle.
Yeah, and then as you rest, you put the triangle on. So, the part that I want to get used to is for me, and it's kind of like almost like I can knee smash the guard to get to the back side, so you get to the front side. So here, once again, so long step, step, foot break. Okay. Circle, knee smash, pop. So I've got this ability to come around the top side to get the arm instead of trying to settle here where his frames have the inside there, and he's going to win that battle. Does that kind of make sense? So I showed the early one if I can't grip break, and this is one if I can grip break. That this would be a more ideal situation. So, from your hand. Right. What I found for me is, anytime I step to here, they get the ability to kind of catch the half guard and reap and things like that. Where I find if I come to here, so here, if I go right here, I'll get a far better grip break. Just that, because I'm on that. Second is, because I'm on this position, it's hard for him to catch the half. Yeah, cool, thank you. Perfect. Yeah, so, yeah, I don't want, because I can't get the inside position. It's good for me.
Yeah.
You know, as long as we acknowledge what's going on. And because you've come up, it's really hard to hold that half guard. My foot kind of rolls straight out of it. You almost want it out. Tapping it down. Okay, 4 minutes of self-learning. Without Emma? She's learned enough. Okay. So do you three want to work together? Do you three want to work together and just do one or both and drop it out? So do two each. Okay, 1, 2, 3. So control position. My partner creates space, boom, underhooks, does correctly the shot, right? So as it's coming up from here, I'm just gonna take the bottom arm for my come on. Because he has to post in that arm to come up. So if he's beating me to the position, right, so on the side, I'm gonna go slow. So on the side control, and I'm like, man, didn't I expect you to be good at jiu-jitsu? Switch. Now, the thing that I like about this is that I actually don't have to have the head. So to stop it from rolling me over, all I'm going to do is I'm going to do a hip thrust. So I'll thrust my hips forwards. And now as it goes through off, I just drop my hip down. I come underneath. And this will put me in a position that he can't risk through the elbow very well. And I can start the attack. If my partner's really savvy and starts to defend it exceptionally well, right, from here, take the top arm, go to the opposite side, and now I'm moving in a better position. So I can kind of go elbow to elbow, yeah. So one of the things that, when I first started to do this, was I'd kind of go here, and I'd go like, aha, and I'd just go like that, and I'd almost let him come up. So as I start to come up, watch what happens to his hand, because they pick you, it almost gives me Kimura, because they have to drive over. Yeah.
You're not worried about them trying to take your back there either.
I want them to take my back.
So you really big, because the finish mechanics are amazing.
Oh man, like, come here. Is that okay if I use your daddy?
Come sit with me, Andy.
It'd be easier to finish the second.
Yeah, man, the second to it. Because you commit 100% to it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So jump on your back, Scotty. So,
are there any kids on the mat these days?
Mikey! So, from here, once again, Scotty frames inside and like shrugs the unhook. So, boom. So, I know he has to come up. So, I'll try and take this now. Watch carefully. Lift and drive. And as long as I'm... Yeah, so he's here. Watch. As the hand comes through, I simply backstroke. No, I let him come up. And put the hook in as he comes up. You've got nowhere to go. And of course I've got the hook. You can, yeah.
Yeah.
So as long as you have that hook, and then if he's stronger than me and pulls the arm in, okay, arm drag, we're still back up into, like, I can play a whole combination of that. Okay guys, line up, 1, 2, 3.